Even low carb pros like ourselves can make a mistake every now and then. I just want to say, I did it again. Hey there, NJRoute22.com with another low carb keto carnivore chat. And today I'm going to talk about just a recent mistake I made. It wasn't a big mistake, it wasn't a punishing mistake, it didn't have any long lasting results, but it had enough of a result for me to talk about it here. I cook for my family all the time. I cook high carb products for my family who don't follow the low carb or at least the carnivore rule that I do. They are generally a lot lower carb than pretty much 95% of the rest of the world. They're pretty good. I mean, they get their starches and their carbs in there, but not excessively. There's no 10-foot long hoagies here and triple decker sandwiches. Like, my kids get half a piece of toast in the morning, and that's it. They eat carbs, but not excessive. But anyway, I was cooking. One of the meals I was making was, I sometimes look in the fridge and I see, like, you know, these things are going to be done in a couple days and no one plans on eating them, so I'm going to cook it up for the family. So I made a cookie, onions and peppers and some sausage that we had laying around. And man, I swear, I did it on my Holland grill outside. But the smell of peppers and onions were a little, I used coconut oil in there and garlic and oh man, salt and pepper. It's so good. I mean, the smell of caramelized onions collectively with the peppers, and then the sausage gets going, and man, it reminded me of like the old Italian delis in the New York City area and down at the shore. Sometimes you go on the boardwalk, you could see those guys, or at any kind of street festival, you see those people putting those massive grills up of sausage and onions and peppers. You can't resist. So I delved into it with my family a little bit. Just a few spoonfuls, maybe five small teaspoons or a regular coffee spoons worth of sausage, peppers, and onions. And you know what? Onions, if you are like carnivore for a long time with no mistakes, and then you eat onions, you really can feel it instantly. You don't feel like the worst, but you could feel inflamed. You feel kind of like, not jiggly, but kind of like just, inflamed is the best word. You're full, but just generally uncomfortable. And from what I've read, that onions are very inflammatory to your internal organs, and everything inside just does, especially since I haven't had them in ages. It really made me feel just not good. Just sluggish and just generally feeling uneasy. And I'm telling you, if you're going down the path of being carnivore light or what have you, you're going to feel it if you do it right. Because if you feel bloated and inflamed like that, it just adds another piece of resolve to your future efforts, because I'm not going to do it again. I just didn't like it for like 6 hours after we ate that meal. I didn't feel good, and I'm not doing it anymore. I don't care how good it tastes. Maybe I can just like remember what it tastes like and then remember how I felt afterward, and that'll be more than enough. I'll just watch everybody else enjoy it. So that's it. If you like this video, please hit the bell and the subscribe and all that, and stay tuned for future videos. We do 3 a week. Have a good day.